wraps up chaotic weekend of if I hold that, that's better. Of racing, I think all in all, that sums up. It was just chaos. Had a good result 2 weeks prior at Club Champion. There they did, finished on the podium, which was third. Got to share the podium with Pete and Callow, with Jackson Callow. It was awesome, but knew there was heaps of time left in the car because of the real pace of the car hadn't really been shown realistically because of the tyre issues I had. But no point boring that now with you. Just got the stats up here to kind of run through because my mind's a bit hazy on everything this weekend that's happened. Qualifying started, I think I finished 8th. Ended up PB in qualifying by 0.4, but still, I just for some reason had a mental barrier. I couldn't get down to where I needed to. Heat 1 started 7th, and then from there I ended up in, I think, no, 7th, and then ended up in some chaos towards the end. That's right, finished 9th. You'll see that on the footage. So from there, heat 2 started 7th, dropped back to 8th in the first couple of laps, made that spot back up, got to 6th, and then dropped back. So it was a bit of back and forward. Yet again, didn't have the tyre pressures right. So heat 3, I got punted. Yeah, was in the battle with some guys. I probably wasn't quick enough to hold one of them back, but the other two I could have. Still chasing the setup in the kart. Got punted by a bloke, and my rear bar bolt ended up, like, instead of being nice and straight like that, it was like doing a semicircle with the bar folded up. And then the rest of the race, for whatever reason, the kart never felt the same. I didn't see the bar, but makes sense with the bar facing the exhaust is, not gonna help the kart at all. So heat 3 was damage limitations and finished 8th. Now the final, what can I say about the final that wouldn't describe chaos? I honestly don't know. It was, started 7th, there was heaps of chaos at the start. A repeat offender in our class all the time, before the lights are out, he's always half a cart out of the tram lines that we're meant to stay in until the light goes. From there, push the whole field across, and then from there caused a huge stack into turn 1. I got up to 6, then from there, I believe it was a little, it was trying to, after the stack, trying to avoid all the other drama that was going on. So it got clipped and still stayed in 6, and then me and the dude battling for 6, he unloaded me, like, by unloading, like, he was on my bar and virtually just sent me, so I had no brakes, and my car did a full 360 virtually and screwed me, and then ended up getting back next to him, and then he ended up turning in on me. So it was, it was a pretty shit end to it. And you don't have to unload people to pass them. It's a thing called an overtake usually. You don't unload people, but he seems to think there's no issue with it. So, what? Yeah, you know, I'm not gonna beat a dead horse on that issue. And because he did the same to my other mate Pete in the race as well. He unloaded him as well and thinks it's all a joke, but unfortunately, it's not. Like, when you're doing it all the time. It's just stupid. It's just absolutely stupid. If you can't beat them, don't just unload them or, you know, put them in harm's way. It's just stupid. So, finished 7th. But all in all, what can I say about the weekend? I learned a lot about the kart setup, a bit more on where things need to be. Went faster again in the heats than I did. I finally got into my target. My target was to finish where I qualify, and I think I did that. I'd have to see the final points and then get into the 46s. So I pulled a lap out of nowhere. I think that was heat 2, got deep enough into the 46s for me to be happy. The lap came to me and the car felt good. After that, I don't know what today. I just really wasn't switched on. There's no excuses. I just, wasn't anywhere to be found realistically, mentally. It was just a body just operating a car and the mind was off. So, yeah, other than that, awesome weekend. You know, as always, getting to have a laugh with all the lads. Just some quick thank yous to wrap this one up. We'll start with Poppy. Thank you very much, Craig. Without you, as always, none of this happens, mate. And thank you for the lend of the tent this weekend. Absolute saviour. Thanks to JD Designs for the helmet. Makes me look special out there, but not as fast as what it could make me be. And from their Autosport as well for supplying all the gear. Massive thanks to Jake, Pete, Dante, Kyle, Paul, Jackson, like all those lads that, you know, offered out help or, you know, were there to help when we needed it. It was absolutely awesome, especially obviously Jake. continuously spending the spanners, who has just bought a kart, so now he'll be racing, which is awesome, in our class as well. I'd like to thank Coffee Table Racing as well. Yeah, without your support, none of this is possible. And now everyone's talking about Coffee Table Racing, so watch out for us in the future. And they'll be doing big things. And from then, it would be good to have a race one day on a Saturday so you could relax afterwards and like go out to a dinner or have some drinks with some mates. Like afterwards, being on a Sunday, I'm wrecked and we've got to go back to work tomorrow, which is the only downside. But other than that, we're having a break for a bit. The next round of Festival State Cup's in Whyalla in like, I think, 2 to 3 months. We're skipping that. And then we're coming back for round four at MONARTO. Spent heaps of time there previously, but the cart's changed since then. So I'll get back out there and practice and see if I can't get into the magical 46s around there for me, which is huge. From there, what else can I say? Like, I mean, it's just chaos this weekend. But good fun, learnt heaps, had some good laughs, got to see some mates on the podium as well, which is awesome. All in all, we will see you guys in a couple of months. Until then, don't forget to throw your likes, subscribe, comments, everything below. Massive help, because of like, you know, without you guys doing that, I don't end up where I need to try to get some couple of views. Oh, quick last shout out, thank you very much to Lee Cocker, pumping me up all weekend, calling me Benji Marshall as well. I wish I had his bank balance. Whoop. And that'll be a job for my editor to get rid of that word. And from there, yeah, Lee, it's always a pleasure, mate. Always a good laugh. And, mate, thanks heaps for coming down and doing what you do, because you provide some good laughs over the mic. Thanks to all the volunteers and everything. Yeah, without you guys, none of us can sit here and do this all. And until next time, guys, we'll see you soon.